Live from the ABC Channel 13 studios, it's Houston's own Debra Duncan.
Good morning, ladies. Good morning. Good morning, ladies. Get ready for your summer makeovers today because we're talking about the hottest new looks for women, new lipsticks, new colors,
new styles. You think it's all about women? Today it's about men. Come on out, men. It's all about, we're sick of it. We're not taking it anymore. Today, we're going to take care of the men in Houston. That's right, let's hear it for the men. So tired of all this women's stuff.
Equal pimp time.
That's right, guys. That's right. We have needs too, Debra. We have needs too. That's right. Those are my friends.
Then I guess today on Debra Duncan, we're making over men, which is not a bad thing. There is a need out there because when we asked people to send letters on why their man needs a makeover, we were overwhelmed. Hundreds of people wrote, they emailed, they called us. Mothers, sisters, wives begged us to make over their men. So we brought in fashion stylist Lawrence Zarian and hairstylist Scott Merrick from Tifosi, and they had their work cut out for them. For example, our first two makeovers are double trouble. They're twins who nominated themselves.
I'm Paul, and I need a makeover.
I'm Mike. I do, too. I look like a 90s reject.
Change is good, they say.
Any kind of change, please.
This is my motif of I don't care.
He looks...
You got your gut hanging out.
You're wearing white socks with black shoes. You got paint right here. You're wearing a muscle tee, and you have no muscles. You got a gut that's five times bigger than mine.
How about a haircut?
God, somebody do something with this.
Baby, I'm ready to go.
You need new shoes.
A change. Just overall, I want to see something different that I can't do myself.
I definitely want to change. I want to look better.
Definitely get a date. Yeah.
Help us
please
both.
Please help us both.
Please.
What do I do? What do I do?
Lawrence, I know when you saw this, you thought, oh, boy.
Could relate to the twins, being an identical twin.
That's right, wanted you are one, too.
Wanted to create individual personalities for the boys.
Yeah.
And it was fun.
Yeah, okay, well, before we see them, Debra Jost, you are Mike's fiancé. And at one point, you almost thought about calling off the wedding because it was pretty bad.
He's so 1988.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you know, not even 90, 88.
It's embarrassing.
Yeah,
it's embarrassing.
Yeah. Well, you know, we think that after you see his makeover, you're probably going to rush the wedding date and move it up a whole lot. And Catherine Castillo is actually Paul's ex-wife. Yeah. And we understand that... perhaps the breakup might have been due to a little bit of...
I don't want to say that. That wouldn't...
that wasn't the whole reason.
But it helped.
Contributed.
But it, yeah.
Yeah, well, we're thinking that after you see him today, you might want him back. Oh, yeah.
That's another show.
Yeah, that's a whole other show. I'll get with this after the show. We'll book that one. Well, let's take another look at the before pictures of Paul and Mike Castillo. They are twins. Are you ready to see what they look like now? Identical twins?
Yes, we are.
Oh, but now you look different with your different styles. Lawrence, tell us what
we did is we took them to Rep Limited Big and Tall here in Houston on Westheimer, and we gave them their own individual looks. Now, Mike wanted to dress up. Mm-hmm. We put him in the two-piece, three-button suit. We did the monochromatic shirt and the tie and gave him a classic, sophisticated look that will take him from the office.
Yeah, and I know the two were actually joking about having the big guts and stuff like that, but you know what? When your clothes fit properly, it just you look good.
Look at this.
I'm skinny.
When you're a twin supermodel, this is what happens. And we put Paul, a couple layered, we did the plaid shirt, we did the khaki pants. And he wanted to be comfortable and really separate himself from his twin brother so they could create their own identities.
They actually don't look like they're twins anymore.
But the love is still there, right,
That's
guys?
Right. I love you, man.
Now, tell me what you said backstage. Backstage, you said, I feel like a college guy.
Yeah, I feel like I'm a kid again. I feel like I'm 10 years younger, and I was like, this is not me.
But it is you.
I miss my shirt and my jeans and my tattered clothes.
It is you. You know, audience, it is
you. Is this me?
Of your personality, the fun, kind of crazy type of guy, the young college type of guy, and then we have the sophisticated man.
And you know, being twins, you could swap clothes.
That's right.
Oh, there you go. Two for one. All right, ladies, what do you think about your men?
Unbelievable.
Beautiful.
Unbelievable.
Why you couldn't dress like that when we were married?
Wow. All right, then.
Wow.
Okay. Wow, it's amazing. Now, Scott, what did you do with the hair here? Because there were some hair issues going on
earlier.
Yeah,
we removed a lot of it. We had a great time working with the artistic design team from Tafosi's Salon, Shannon Hunt and Carrie Costello seated right over my shoulder. And first of all, we removed, believe it or not, a lot of hair from these guys. They had a lot more hair than this. But we wanted to keep the longer lengths. We felt that was suitable. Their hair was very, very black also, very monochromatic, and we wanted to break that up very subtly, so we added a few highlights, just a few shades lighter than their natural, just to break it up and give it some dimension and really catch the light.
But then again, there it is. They're identical twins, but you can see how much a hairstyle can change someone's look. So.
You bet.
And also the way the clothes change them. I mean, their energy's different, the way they're standing is different. The outfit really makes you feel and stand a certain way.
Yeah, we hear that Paul is heading off to a college campus now.
Okay.
Well, thank you all very much. You look great. Okay, well, we just had to answer the plea of one woman who was desperate to get Dad back into the dating game. Problem is, his hair, it's a little... Well, you can see that for yourself. Ivy Golden's daughter is hoping a makeover will put some spark into dear old Dad.
Dear Debra, help. Or help my father. He has divorced last year and had tried very hard to feel better about his life in general. His hair, as you can see, needs help. His eyebrows and mustache also need some pick-me-up. He used to dress really nice and now anything goes. I hope that you choose my father for the makeover. I think by getting some personal attention, it will make a big difference in his outlook. And who knows, maybe even a partner for life. Thank you.
Letitia is Ivy's daughter, and she's here this morning. And is that your son next to you?
This is my son, Christopher.
Okay, so your dad, you want to get him back into the dating game and the whole bit, huh?
Oh, my God. Well, you saw the picture.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, the hair, the mustache.
Yeah, it was very nice of you to write in and try to get him some help. And we're going to see Ivy in just a minute. Also coming up, this dad is cutting corners, even on his haircuts, so his wife can stay home with their kids. We'll get him a professional cut for a change. We'll be right back with more Men Makeovers after this.
Thank you.
Hoping to get her dad looking great and back into the dating pool. He's divorced. Well, here's Ivy before. You want to see what he looks like now?
Yeah.
Ladies, get ready to get yourself a date with Ivy. Come on out here. What do you think of dad now?
Ow! Baby!
All right! You know, and did you notice how he walked out? I gotta tell you, because you weren't walking like this earlier. He walked out and he did this number here. You've got some attitude now. So what do you think? Is this spunkier than you've ever been?
Oh, yeah. Spunkier than I've ever been.
Well, now come on now, Ivy. Look at the other one. Now look at you now. What do you think about that? Scott, what'd you do here? And a lot of times we get kind of stuck in what we were comfortable in. The last thing we were comfortable in, we will have forever. But what did you do here? And was it tough trying to get
Ivy
to change?
Believe it or not necessarily with Ivy, though, because as we got into our consultation, he confessed to me he's been several many different wilder colors, his hair.
Oh, okay? So he's trying to act like he's a shy, quiet type.
That's a whole other story in itself. Turns out his construction team from Florida he works with, they sit around and do hair color on each other. I think that's just great.
But, that's a whole other show. Hold on.
I know, I'm telling you.
Ivy, what's going on here?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Scott, go on now. Yeah, because you know, we tell our hairstylist everything. But anyway, go on.
Ivy's got a great disposition on life. He wanted to be blonde. Hey, why not? Let's do it. So we took him a couple of different shades of blonde, kind of subtly mixed them together. Tinted his facial hair as well, and just gave him an updated cut.
Yeah.
He looks great. Took a few years off, I think.
Yeah, it absolutely did. All right, we'll check back in with you a little bit later on and see if blondes really do have more fun. Let's talk about the clothing here. Lawrence.
Well, what we did is because of the blonde hair, we kept him in those earth tones. We kept him in shades of brown and cinnamon. He's off to go get a girl. He's dating.
Ivy, can you come back?
Feeling so hot, Ivy went to go get some clothes.
Ivy?
Hi.
We're not done with you.
Ivy went to go get some chicks. What do you do?
There are women backstage. That's what's going on here.
He has his pocket full of business cards saying, call me. Well, we went to Marshall's and we decided to get an outfit that matched the hair. So we stayed with the earth tones, we stayed with shades of browns and taupes. And what I like about this, when going out into the dating scene again, you look like you made an effort, but you didn't try too hard.
Yeah.
So it's accessible. Oh, Ivy, you're gonna have chicks falling at their feet.
Oh,
at your feet.
Okay.
Look at the attitude, the head nod. Yeah, I know. I know what's going on.
Okay, well, for our next makeover, one of our most touching letters came from Lisa Cool and the sacrifices her husband, Chris, has made for their two children.
Dear Debra, I am writing about the male makeover show. I have an absolutely gorgeous husband that really deserves a makeover. My husband and I have been married for 7 years. Most of that time, I have bought all of his clothes, cologne, everything. Well, now, Debra, since the birth of our first child, Kristen, almost 4 years ago, I now even cut my husband's hair to save those few extra pennies. By the way, I'm not a licensed beautician. My husband has sacrificed wearing the best clothes, getting the best haircuts, etc., so that I could be home to raise our children, Kristen and John. I feel so honored to give him such a special surprise that he so deserves for being an awesome husband and the best daddy in the world. Thank you. Sincerely, Lisa Cool.
Oh. Now, Lisa, he looks like he's neatly trimmed in the whole bit and wears nice clothes. So it wasn't so much that you wanted him to have a dramatic new look. You wanted him to have the experience.
Right. And just a little fine tuning. Like
yeah.
His eyebrows.
Okay. Now, Scott, don't you love me? Don't you love to hear these stories when they say, well, my wife has been cutting my hair off for the last
time. I didn't know that yesterday. Carrie did, Chris, and I wasn't privy to that information. I think that's wonderful.
Yeah.
But we had a great time getting him together also.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well. Oh, yeah. Yes, the little baby said, yeah. All right. Well, let's have Chris come on out here. Come on out, Chris. Oh, yeah. Now, if we get close up on the hair here, we can see that you guys had a little fun. There's a little color sparked in there.
There is a little color in there. We used Paul Mitchell the Color to bring up some highlights, kind of blonde. He's got great hair texture. You can see all that curl. And we really wanted to play that up and accentuate it.
The nice thing about curly hair is if you don't cut it correctly, it's okay. You can hide a lot in that curly hair. So you've been doing a good job. It's all right. Okay, so what do you think? Especially putting color in. A lot of men think, whoa, no color in my hair.
Well, you're always on the verge of doing something, exciting, but you just don't want to take that step, and this kind of gave me the opportunity, so the color was kind of cool. I liked it. It was a neat little twist to me.
Yeah, and a lot of times when we're working and doing our things for our family, you do it because you love your family, and and sometimes we don't express that all the time, so when you found out that your wife wrote in and was doing this makeover for you, how did it make you feel?
Great. Well, she said I'm the one sacrificing. Really, she is. I mean, she does all of it, and she stays home and works with them. So when she did that, I mean, I really felt undeserving, but it was great. I mean, it really touched me. Aww. Back there listening to it. She's great.
Well, you look good, too, with the clothing here. And Lauren,
we just went for classic detailing with flat front black pants, classic gray shirt, because when Chris's wife said a little fine tuning, I thought if you go classic, and with that face, you've got a great look from head to toe.
Yeah, and what I love too is that the hair suggests a little fun, a little
Absolutely.
Wildness, but then the clothes kind of, gives that, so it's kind of like you're that mysterious type of man there. All right, well, what do you think about Daddy? Thank you very much. Well, what happens when you're a cool kid, but your dad is not?
Nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love drives a man insane. From my will, one to three. In this gray streak, I'm fine.
Well, the next Jerry Lee Lewis tries to turn his dad into a hip dude.
Hi, Miss Debra. My name is Travis Bishop, and I know how to dress and entertain. I'm Miss Debra. My name is Travis Bishop, and I know how to dress and entertain. The problem is my manager. He wants to play in my band, but he's just not cool enough. Can you help me, please? He's not only my manager, he's my dad.
With us this morning. Hi there, Travis. So you're just wishing your dad was a little more
hip and cool?
Yeah.
Yeah. What would you like to see him look like? More like you, maybe?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? All right. Okay, Mom, when he said he wanted Dad to look even cooler, were you afraid of what he might come up with?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's kind of young.
Yeah. Okay, well, you want to see what Gary looks like now, folks? Let's see what he looked like before. Let's get another before if we can. All right, okay. Well, you know, nice dad, but not, you know, not the hippest guy in town until now. Gary, come on out here. So now, Travis, what do you think?
I think he looks good.
I think he looks good, too. All right, well, Gary, what do you think? You start hanging out with your son looking like this now?
I think so. I hope I pull too many of them women away from it.
This is cute. You guys actually performed together. And, Travis, you were in our talent show that we had not too long ago. And you're a singer, and you play the piano. And so you're his manager. So you guys have more than just the average father-son relationship.
Right, a little bit more.
All right, well, let's talk about what you did here, Lawrence.
Well, once again, we went to Rep Limited Big and Tall on Westheimer, and, you know, he said, my son wants me to be fun. Travis said, Dad, I want you to wear fun, cool clothes so I'm not embarrassed. Well, we put him in these great clothes, the khaki pants, the yellow tee, the drink-inspired overshirt, which we sort of agreed on together. And I think it's a fashion score, because also the energy's there again.
Yeah.
He's having fun. He knows that his son is going to love it. Travis, right?
Yeah.
You guys sort of match each other right there. I'm seeing a fashion score right here.
Yeah. And it's funny, a lot of times we focus on this with plus-size women, and we say, okay, yes, you can be fun and spunky. Same thing with plus-size men. You can do stuff that's fun and trendy.
Absolutely. There's no reason why you shouldn't. And dress in something that makes you feel comfortable, because if you feel comfortable, you'll look good.
Yeah.
And I think this looks good.
Yeah, and comfortable for on the road.
Debra, I just want to interject. We were still a little reclamped from the last segment about Chris and Lisa and the sacrifices they're making. So we're giving Lisa a day of beauty, compliments of Tifosi Salon and Day Spa. She needs it. She deserves it. So we look forward to that. And I'm sorry, I didn't mean to go off there, but Gary, it's all about product. We introduced Gary to styling gels and waxes from Paul Mitchell to give that real textury look. And it's a very updated look. It looks great on him.
Yeah, it looks fun. It matches the clothes. Okay, well, in fact, you two are going to perform for us a little bit later on in the show, so you want to stay around for that. It'd be a lot of fun. Okay, well, another viewer, Letitia, was also desperate for some help with her dad. She says her dad used to be the Casanova of the neighborhood, but now he's in need of a little help. And, okay, Letitia, what was the situation here?
My dad does not know the meaning of style at all.
Your grandson's going, or his grandson's going, no.
He loves his papa, but he does not know the meaning of style.
Well, he used to, though, right?
Well, my mom said back in the day, I guess that was a very long time ago, that he had his clothes made and that he was like the Dapper Don.
Oh, but now we're looking at, yeah, we saw the before, Dapper Don, but now we're looking, this is not a Casanova look right here. We can't even pull down the other leg to match the length of the other.
He will go out dressed like that.
Oh, boy.
He will go out in public dressed like that.
Oh, boy. Like leave the house.
Yes. My mom and I just don't know what to do with him anymore.
You know what that was? Basically, he had his clothes made, and he was looking dapper and the whole bit so that he could catch your mom.
Exactly.
After the marriage, he let himself go. He just let himself go, but not anymore. You want to see the new and improved David?
Yeah.
All right, David. Shut on out here, Casanova. Any idea that they were thinking this about you?
No.
None at all, huh?
Nope.
But did you notice a change in, for example, we saw a picture of you in a nice suit, and then we saw you in this particular outfit here.
basically, there's nothing wrong with that, you don't think?
Or? I don't think so. It's clothes.
Clothes is clothes. You're a practical man. That's right. If it's clothes, you're covered up. That's all you need. Doesn't matter how you're covered up. But what do you think about what you have on right now?
I like it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, Lawrence?
Well, you know, David got the babe years ago, so the clothes, as you said, weren't that important. But now the babe, wife is saying, I want my husband to dress up a little bit again with the daughter. And we put him in a pair of classic pleated pants. And blue is the hot color for men this year. So we put him in a wonderful dress shirt, but we didn't add the tie, rolled up the sleeves, made it more casual.
Uh-huh.
And I'm thinking Don Juan's back and ready to play. Yeah.
I think
And we went to Marshall's.
And that's a blue that looks good on almost any skin tone.
Absolutely, yeah. Wonderful
okay.
shades of blue.
And so let me ask the wife here. So ma'am, do you think this is a lot better than what?
Yeah, I think I'll marry him again.
You think he'd marry him again?
Yeah. We're just a few days shy of our 34th wedding anniversary.
Oh,
so.
Oh how sweet. Right for these last 30-something years. All right, well, you look great.
Thank you.
Keep that up and get rid of those shorts that you had. Okay, so you think women are the only ones who primp in front of the mirror? Well, ladies, more and more of you are going to have to fight for a spot in front of that mirror. Up next, what men are putting on their faces to get glowing and rosy. Lawrence is going to show us. Products on their faces, some of them secretly. You thought you knew what they were doing in that bathroom. They were using your stuff. But finally, a company has developed a line of face care products exclusively for men. So no more hiding. So when it says exclusively for men, then they're more likely to go to the store and buy it, huh?
Well, you know what the reality is? A lot of men will not go to a department store to buy skincare.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I use my dad as my fashion scale. He will say, oh, it's too girly. I'm not going to the department store, and I'm not buying something a woman puts on her face. Well, Dad, relax, because things have changed.
Uh-huh.
Wonderful new skincare line. It's Nivea for Men Face Care, and is the first mass market skincare line for men. Men. And I just want to say this. We are also going to give each makeover a proper skincare kit from Nivea for Men.
Oh,
so guys, you're going to score. You're going to look good. Great face care.
because you know, for so long, men acted like they didn't care. And now, they're rushing to the plastic surgeon's office just as much as women are, and the whole bit. But by the way, this looks good.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I like what he did.
And he did it behind he did it behind the air.
No, but anyway,
let's not play that game. So the whole point is, what I love about this is 70% of the men in America are taking more time and taking care of themselves. And men are spending just as much time as women are in front of the mirror getting ready. There's never been a line of skincare exclusively for men because men's skin is oilier, it's a little heavier.
Huh.
So when a man uses a woman's moisturizer, he's putting on something too heavy for his skin. Since my skin is oilier, I need a face moisturizer that's lighter. And it's also 4 easy steps for men with 7 products to choose from.
Okay.
You want to cleanse.
Yeah, yeah.
You want to then shave. You then want to put on your aftershave.
It's a sensitive
and then you want
gel.
To now, use moisturizer.
How important is, obviously, I just use anything to put on my face or my leg, when I shave, or my legs, but any...
This is good, we're bonding. Because you know
anyway,
what the problem was? It's about men today.
What makes this different?
Because it's designed for men's skin, like for the sensitive skin, there's chamomile in the skin, mm-hmm. and there's wonderful nutrients that help soothe the skin.
Well, let's just get someone started right here, because you're not shaving yet, but at some point you
sensitive
will be,
skin.
And so we can go ahead and, there
and
you go.
And why not start?
There, oh, that is, it's very creamy. That's very.
See, I use that as well.
Yeah.
The skincare's taken, I'm 72, so it takes years off.
Just go back there and just let that cool.
Also, you know what? A lot of things that are fantastic are exfoliating. Men should exfoliate their skin as well. Uh-huh. When you exfoliate your skin, you're taking off the top layer, you're removing the dead skin, and you're allowing new skin to grow. This is a wonderful exfoliating cream. Let's have a guy. Come on.
Let's exfoliate.
Let's exfoliate. Okay. Sit right here. Right. What is your name?
Jim McCullough.
Oh, Jim. Wonderful soft crystals. Mm-hmm. All you do is you rub it in the skin. Look at that, ages, endless. Look at that. See
Does
how fantastic
feel good?
That is.
Now, have you ever really used anything like this before?
No.
No. Okay.
No.
Yeah.
Not exfoliated in a while.
Not exfoliated in a while. See, look at it. It's taking years off.
It is.
Endless.
Will it grow hair?
It will. Will it grow hair?
Okay, so that's the exfoliator.
So just keep that on for about 3 days and you'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
What you should do is after you exfoliate your skin, you want to wash your face again and then use their face scrub. You got the face scrub, then you've got the face wash.
Okay.
So you want to take off as many dead layers of skin and then you moisturize your skin.
So basically what you're saying is that women will never get back in the bathroom again. That's
ever,
what you're saying.
Ever.
Okay.
And also, again, what I think is the most exciting news is it's just for men.
Yeah.
It's affordable. It's department store quality, drugstore cost.
Oh, that's
so you can go to your local drugstore, get the skincare.
Heck, I'm going to use it then.
See, that's the whole point, because it's for men. But do you think men get their own things, Debra Duncan? No.
All right.
Leave my stuff alone.
Up next, Lauren shows us the hottest new looks for men this summer.
It's always about women this, women that.
They're hot. They're gorgeous. Enough about the male models you're going to see. What we really want to focus on are this season's newest fashions for men.
I thought you were talking about me.
Well, yeah, we all, well, it goes without saying that you're hot and you're gorgeous.
I don't ask much. Just a round of applause every now and then.
Yeah. Okay, let's take a look at our models.
Hot trends for men this summer. Let's start with our first model. And here we have, come on out, here we have Brian. Now this is a wonderful look. Here we have Brian, and the tip for men this summer is all about fashion and function. You want to buy an outfit that has several functions. This is a wonderful look from Ben Husen, and all we've done is we removed the jacket and the slacks, and we've dressed down the dress shirt and tie with just a pair of jeans.
I like that.
Orange is a hot color. Men are falling into orange this summer because we usually associate orange with fall.
Uh-huh.
But orange is now becoming a permanent staple in the seasonless colors.
And can I tell you, let me just say right now, thank goodness for the purse, because I am so tired of, can you put this in your purse, my sunglasses? Can you carry my keys?
Absolutely.
We've got to carry suitcases because we're carrying your old stuff.
Men now have mail bags. We have backpacks. And we can carry our own stuff because men are becoming independent and individual and will not need anything you have anymore. So, done.
All right, man.
And this look was from Van Heusen, and the shirt was $30 and the tie was $30.
Oh, wow.
Let's bring out our next model. Come on out. And here we have Danny. And once again, Danny is in fashion from Van Heusen. It's a great looking yellow plaid shirt. And this is a wonderful gift for any guy. And also with Father's Day right around the corner, plaid is key this summer. We've got the khaki pants. They were a little bit longer, so we rolled them up. And all the men today are wearing shoes from G.H. Bass. And sandals are very important for all men this summer.
That
wonderful
looks good.
Sandal shoe. And again, we've got the bag,
yeah.
The messenger bag. The shirt from Van Heusen is cotton, and it's $30.
You know what the problem is with some of these fashions here, Lawrence?
Yes?
I would be in my man's side of the closet, too. He'd never be able to find his stuff because, oh, I borrowed that. Sorry.
You just can't let it go,
can you? I can't let it go. Okay, it's about men today, not women. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Danny. Here we have Ross. Let's bring out Ross. And once, ladies. Just soak it up, Ross.
And so are the clothes.
Here we have Ross, and he's wearing fashions from Izod. We've got the microfiber jacket, the microfiber shorts, and once again, I keep talking about fashion and function. This is a golf-inspired look, but what we did is we removed the... Could I talk?
Simmer down now. Simmer down now.
All we did is we removed the golf shoes and the golf clubs, we added a sandal, and we've taken this look from the golf course and walked right into the weekend.
Yeah, and again, that's nice, that lightweight jacket, because sometimes the air conditioning at night, if you're in a club or something like that.
Absolutely, microfiber jacket is key for men this season. Fashions from Izod. Thank you very much, Ross. All right, you know what? I don't even need to introduce him. Let's bring out our next model. Ladies, this is for you. Roger. Just give me 20 seconds. Roger is wearing swim shorts from Izod.
Not interested.
Izod is the official sponsor of the LA Lifeguards.
Oh, okay.
These swimsuits come in 6 different colors. Orange, hibiscus trunks.
The flesh tone color over there.
They're $25. Again, the fashions are from Izod, and for your guy, this... it starts at a young age, doesn't it? The flirting starts... And for men this summer, once again, orange is a hot color. Swimsuit from Izod. Thank you, Roger.
I just wanted to point out, I know Raj and... But you're a bodybuilder, and could you just strike a couple of poses for us?
Just one
little bicep.
Thank you, Roger.
Oh, yeah.
Can I just ask you a favor?
What?
you know what? I'm feeling a little left out. I'm feeling like I have, you know what? I've got a six pack in the fridge. I just want to try something. Let's bring out our next supermodel, Lawrence.
All I have to say
is in Los Angeles, we had that earthquake a couple years ago, in 94. I lost my chest, I lost my arms, lost it all in the earthquake. And FEMA has not come back to build. I got it going on. Come on, touch it, come on. Touch, yeah, come on.
Oh, that's not a six pack, that's a keg, baby.
Not a six pack, it's a keg. I give her my blood, I give her my sweat, and what do I get?
You look good.
Obviously not as good as Roger.
Well, Roger's not wearing any clothes.
Oh, you want me to take my clothes off?
No! Huh? Next! Up next. Coming up next, a wife says thank you to her dedicated husband who has stood by her through sickness and health.
Stay. You're not coming over here. Just go on.
Scott. Says she wanted a makeover for her husband, not so much because he needed it, but because he deserved to be pampered. Debbie was in a car accident recently, and she says her husband showered her with love and support throughout the entire healing process. Good morning, Debbie.
Hi.
This is one of those things, again, that when we get married, we take the vows, and it was something that was not unusual for him to do, but it's one thing for you to believe this person's going to stand by you and do this. Mm-hmm. It's another thing to see it.
Yes, it is.
What was the thing that just touched you the most during this healing process for you?
He never complains. Never complains about anything. I had the car wreck, and he would go to work, come home, take me to the bathroom, put me back in bed, go back to work, come home, make me something to eat. And then right after that, I went and had my annual checkup and found a lump in my breast. And thank God it was benign. So he stood right there with me the whole time. And then I got really sick again and have been suffering with asthma a lot. And he never, ever, ever complains.
How are you doing with the effects of the car accident? Is that pretty much healed?
It's every day is a good day, bad day.
But he makes it better.
Makes it a lot better.
All right. Well, we want to meet Gary Archer. Gary, come on out here.
Oh, my God.
We're going to try to get Gary a teeth makeover next, but Gary, take those teeth out of there. You just had to have some fun.
My mother is going to kill me.
But isn't that what a lot of it's about, is a sense of humor? If you have
sure.
a sense of humor, you can get through a lot
that's
of things.
Right. And that's what it's about.
Now, Gary, look, this is a big difference here. You just took 20 years off of you. Wow, okay, Scott.
Thanks to these guys.
Yeah, Scott, tell us what you did here. I mean, we can see kind of what you did here, but it just is amazing how just a little bit, because it's short hair, you would think you couldn't do too much, but you did.
Believe it or not, we didn't change much on his cut. We just kind of shaped it up. He was ready for one. It's just, again, it's all on the product. It's how to style. Now, we did talk to Gary about color, and he was a little hesitant at first, so we decided to go with a demi-permanent from Paul Mitchell that will wash out gradually and just blend his gray in, not permanently cover it up. But he liked it so much, we didn't stop there. We decided to go for it, and we did permanent highlights in his hair also. So I think he's hooked now. Like so many men now, men are visiting salons more and more. 30 years now, it was the 70s that men started going into salons that were before that just for women. And it's a big part.
Yeah, because it was the barber shop before.
It was barber shops and beauty salons. And then in the 70s came the unisex salons. And 30 years later, it's stronger than ever. Men are a viable part of our business. They come in for cuts, for colors, businessmen, executives. I have so many executives in my clientele.
Who's pickier, the men or the women?
Men, by far, men are picky. I mean, when some women, you know, are picky, and when they're picky. But men, generally,
know
are
exactly
more picky.
What they want. Mm-hmm. Well, Debbie, what do you think?
I think we need to go out on a date.
Oh, yeah. And mostly, what do you think? Because I know a lot of times people too, they say, I earned my gray, and it's kind of, you know, scary to go to a color because I think it will look not natural. This looks natural.
It looks natural.
They
looks
did a great job.
All right. And Lawrence, with the clothes, it matches the hair.
Gary, what did we call this look? California cool.
California cool.
And what I like about it, it's casual. We have them in a jacket, so we've kept up the sophistication. Crisp white dress shirt, pair of jeans. And the wife wanted the jacket. Like, want to see my husband in a jacket.
Yeah.
So we did it, so we compromised. And again, the fashions are from Marshalls. And this gentleman really touched my spirit. Very kind, loving man. So made me over as well.
You bless me. Thank you.
But I love it. I love it. Some spiky hair here, and it's all in the right product. And a lot of times people have to experiment over and over again before they find the one that can actually make their hair stand up. So show us what you used, actually.
Okay. Well, on most of the gentlemen today, and even on Lawrence, we used some of the wax products. And the wax products are becoming more and more popular all the time. They're more it's a finishing product, but they're more forgiving than hairsprays. So once you spray hair with a hairspray, it pretty much stays right there. The waxes are a lot more moldable and pliable, so you can reshape throughout the day and get different looks. So if you want texture, the hair is standing up a little bit, or even for more control, laying down. And I'll show you, if this gentleman will have a seat right here and hold this for me. I brought two different types of waxes today. One is a dry wax, which is very reminiscent of the old butch waxes from the 50s, and if you'll hold that for me. And then we also, a little bit more pliable, a little bit more moldable, are the wet waxes, and this is it's called Wax Works right here, and if you'll hold that for me also. They wash out of the hair real easy, and you can get a lot of nice shapes with them. And you'll see immediately, as the product goes on the hair, how you're changing the texture up a little bit, and you're adding a lot of shine. That's another good benefit of the wax products.
And getting hair to stand up in Houston can be a problem sometimes.
It can be with our climate. But
all right.
So see, in just a few seconds there, we've changed his look quite considerably. We've added a lot of shine, and we've given him a very contemporary look.
And that took nothing to do.
No, nothing at all. Just a little product on your hands to the hair. And then watch this. If you wanted to change the look, that's what I mean by how pliable and remoldable it is. Okay, hairspray, you wouldn't be able to do that.
Yeah.
It would have stayed where you put it the first time.
Plus, you know, hairspray doesn't seem as masculine as this wax.
No, not even the ones for men. I still don't use. We really like more of the wax products for finishing a lot. See, and now he's got it more texture to give.
Thank you very much.
Real simple.
We'll be right back. And remember, we have that performance coming up from one of our makeover candidates and his son. Duncan.
Can change diapers with the best of them.
It took a while for my family, I think, to accept that my parents, I'm an attorney.
They traded in their briefcases for diaper bags. From CEO to PTA, why these men decided to be stay-at-home dads. That's Monday's Debra Duncan.
Every
day I'm here. I want to thank stylist Lauren Jarian, also Marshalls for our clothes. And by the way, all of our makeover guys, you get to keep your clothes. Isn't that good?
Yay!
Tifosi for the new hairstyles for all the guys. Thank you very much. We leave you today with the rock and roll sounds of one of our makeover candidates. Travis Bishop was a son who wrote in and said, make my dad cool, and dad is cool.